My life was in shambles. I had come back to my husband, and it was abusive, and I had to have him arrested. I had to have him arrested because he tried to run me over with my own car. So the relationship had been abusive, physically abusive for years, but I thought that was normal. You see, I suffer from low self-esteem. I come from an alcoholic family. My father was an alcoholic, so there was always drama, per se. So when I met my husband, I thought, this is it. Had kids. I didn't realize that he came with his own issues. And I didn't know what to do because I didn't know it was a problem at the time. So I am a survivor of domestic violence. But what happened is it made me feel like a failure as a wife. You can't even be a good wife. And I spiraled into drugs like I had always done. Drugs and alcohol have always been a part of me. Yeah. The kids pretty much walked away from me. They said, we're not finna do this with you. They were old enough by now, and they walked away. And of course, that just fed into the poor me's. So I dived into this drug and alcohol lifestyle. It wasn't long before I was doing things that I wasn't proud of. And the next thing I know, I'm on Main Street in Brockton doing what I do best to get the next one. And I just looked up and I was like, God, if you can just help me. And someone told me about the Mainspring. I seen the big white house. I didn't know what it was. I mean, I'm on Mainspring. Who can't see that big white building? Which is now so beautiful. But and someone said, well, you can go in there. Because I didn't feel like I had anything else to live for. I went in and they asked me, what was I willing to do? And I said anything.